Hello and welcome to Maths by SAS. This is my 11th lesson of D3, chapter number 6, exercise 6C, that is about equation of straight line in y equals to mx plus c form. In this class, we will be discussing advanced level question number 17. Let's read the question from the book. As the question is long, so I will be reading the question from book and underlining the important terms of the question. Question says, the coordinates of the point P and Q are, P has the coordinates 2 and 3 and Q has the coordinates 9 and 5 respectively. First requirement of the question is that we have to find the coordinates of the point where the line passing through P and Q intersects x-axis. And the second requirement is that given that y is equal to 5 is the line of symmetry for the triangle PQR, find the coordinates of R. Then in the next part, we have to find the distance or length PQ, and then we have to find the length of perpendicular from R to PQ. So what we have to do in order to find the equation of line that passes through P and Q, we have to find the equation of line in the form y equals to mx plus c. Y equals to mx plus c, where m is the gradient and c is the y intercept. In order to find value of m, we have to use the formula y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. M is 5 minus 3 upon 9 minus 2, which is equal to 2 by 7. Okay, after finding the gradient, what we have to do, we have to find value of c, and equation will take the form y equals to 2 by 7x plus c. In order to find value of c, we can take any point. I'm taking point P, which has the coordinates 2 and 3. Now, instead of y, replace 3. And instead of x, replace 2. 2 by 7 into 2 plus c. Now, equation will take the form 4 by 7 plus c. 3 minus 4 by 7 equals to c. Now, we have to take LCM. 21 minus 4 equals to c. 17 by 7 equals to c. So the equation of line will take the form y equals to 2 by 7x plus 17 by 7. Take the LCM to make this equation free from fraction. 7 will be the LCM, 2x plus 17 equals to y, and 7y equals to 2x plus 17. This is the equation of line which is passing through these two given points. And now the actual requirement of the question is we have to find the coordinates of the point where the line passing through P and Q intersects x-axis. When line cuts x-axis, line meets x-axis, its y coordinate will be equal to 0. So replace y equals to 0 in the given equation, 2x plus 17, 0 equals to 2x plus 17, and minus 17 equals to 2x, and shift 2 to other side, minus 17 by 2 equals to x, or x equals to minus 8 whole 1 by 2 or 8.5. So the required point will be coming as P, Q and R is already given. So we can use any other letter where the line passing through P and Q meets x, line passing through P and Q meets x axis, minus 8 whole 1 by 2 and 0. I hope you are clear about this part. And let's move to the second part of the question, and that says that y is equal to 5 is the line of symmetry, because y is equal to 5 is the line of symmetry of the triangle PQR. We have to find the coordinates of are, first of all, I have drawn the points P and Q for my students, and let me join these two points with the help of ruler, okay, so that we can create a clear triangle here. Let me join these two points with the help of ruler. Okay, let me make it little bold so that my students can see it clearly. And now y is equal to 5, so I have to draw the line at y is equal to 5. This is the line of symmetry. Recall the rule of line of symmetry, that symmetry divides the given shape into equal halves. Symmetry divides the given shape into equal halves. If we look at point Q, that is on the mirror line or line of reflection, so there will be no change in the coordinates of Q under this line of reflection or line of symmetry. But if we look at P, P is at how many units? 1 and 2 units away from the mirror line. So the image of P will be 2 units away or on the other side of the mirror line. Okay, so this will be the position for point R. Let me mark it. This is R, and R has the coordinates 2 and 7. R has the coordinates 2 and 7. And let me join these two points. Okay, so I hope you are clear that how we are creating and how we are completing the triangle and what is the role of line of symmetry. So the coordinates of point R are, this is the second part, 2 and 7. And let's move to the next part, that says the calculate the length PQ. Length PQ, third part is that we have to find length PQ. So if P has the coordinates 2 and 3 and Q has the coordinates 9 and 5, length means that we have to find the distance. Recall the distance formula, that it is equal to x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. Now insert the values in the formula, plug in the values. Distance equals to x2 9 minus 2 whole square plus 5 minus 3 whole square. And then what we have to do, we have to take the square root, and this will become 9 minus 2 is 7 plus 2 square, 49 plus 4, 50 and 53 square root. 53 square root is the length PQ. Length PQ, PQ is square root 53. If it is paper 1, you can leave your working at this stage. But if it is paper 2, you can use calculator and you can get the answer with the help of calculator. 7.28 units is the length. Units is the length. And coming to the last part, that says the length of perpendicular from R to PQ. Now we have to find the length of perpendicular from R to PQ. Let me draw the height from R to PQ. Let's meet it at T. Now what we have to do in order to get length of perpendicular from R to PQ, we have to apply the concept that area of triangle PQR will be equal to half base, that is PQ into height RT. Now area of triangle PQR, for that purpose we will be using the formula half base. Now look at the change in the base. X value is 7, but Y value is changing from 3 to 7. So the height of this triangle or the base of this triangle is 4 multiplied by height, that is 9 minus 2. 9 minus 2, which is equal to 7, equals to half into PQ, which is square root 53 or 7.28, and RT, let me mark it with H, and instead of RT I will be replacing H. Now half goes with half and I will left with 28 equals to 7.28 into H. and 28 divided by 7.28 equals to 8. Now what we have to do, we have to divide 28 divided by 7.28 3.8 equals to 8, or h will be equal to 3.85 to the nearest three significant figures units. I hope you are clear about today's class. For next difficulty level, please catch me in the next class. Watch my lessons, like, share and subscribe the channel, and press bell icon to get the notification of every lesson in time. Thank you very much.